enable. Unleashing the power of creativity and innovation, the Festival of Architecture and Interior Designing is one of the most celebrated design events in the country. Back in its fifth year, the Festival of Architecture and Interior Designing celebrates, shares, and inspires the glory of the Indian architecture and design industry.
Like the kind of diversity that it has young students presenting a lot of programs. There are senior architects who are coming and speaking, there's panel discussion, and also the whole fun part. So I think it's really a festival feel, it's not really a conference feel.
It's an interesting blend of interaction between professionals and also taking a look at what are the new products coming on in the market. So I think it's a good initiative.
I always say that we architects and designers have no common ground to meet. We don't meet on sites with each other because we are all on our own sites. So I think an initiative like this goes a long way in uniting the fraternity.
The whole business of bringing together so much of thought and so much of experience and so much of student body in one event is quite fantastic.
Held in New Delhi, the two-day festival was a design affair to remember. The festival brought together creative minds from across the country to discuss the newer facets of the design fraternity.
It's a really interesting platform because it gets all of us together. There are conversations that need to be had, issues that need to be bounced around. It's also a congregation of similar minds, professionals, people that you know, people that you don't know. Some new work to be seen and also new products.
I think what it does is bring about architectural practices which are very disparate and very varied and bring them on one platform. So you engage with similar problems from different perspectives and you also engage with very different points of view, and I think that enriches the architectural dialogue across the country.
You can already see the difference. A lot of students are interested in participating in the competitions. A lot of young professionals are starting to submit. I think there is quite a bit of difference from what I've seen last year of the panels and what you see today. There's a lot more maturity. So I'm sure over the years it will start to kind of pick it up more.
Focusing on the diverse aspects of creativity this year, the festival's theme was Time to Reimagine, creating a way to kindle imagination and inspiration through the spirit of design.
Reimagine is very close to rethink, you know, because we architects come from a world of creativity. So we are always in some paradigm of some imagination. So this really, you know, motivate us to come up ourselves, our creativity, much beyond than imagination.
Times where there is so much change and so much transformation happening in all of our lives, the way we build, the way we live, I think all of this needs to be reinvented, reimagined, and it needs new visions for that. So I think this topic is very up to date.
As creative professionals, we're always trying to challenge boundaries and figure out what different ways that we can see things. So in that sense, it makes a lot of sense to me.
The Festival of Architecture and Interior Designing 2018 kicked off with an inaugural ceremony by eminent dignitaries from the architecture and design industry. The glittering lamp lighting ceremony was followed by keynote addresses by renowned industry stalwarts and architects who threw light on the changing face of architecture in modern times.
The reimagination bit really has everything to do not just with architecture, but how will we as a society develop? Will we have flying cars? Would there be the need for a kitchen in a modern house? We don't know that. And not knowing it makes the job of imagining what will be required tomorrow tough. The change is not just in the requirements, but also in terms of the methods of construction and the materials of construction. We require materials which are lighter, modular, stronger, and obviously much longer lasting to make these imaginations which we all make into reality.
Architecture, like civilization, is dynamic and evolving. While exciting architecture is being built all over the world and thus expanding the vocabulary of contemporary architecture, we architects in India have to find our balance in design, enabling us to be part of the new and creative experiments ahead, as well as be part of what has gone before. We work in a world of computer-aided design with its digital design technology. We need to include all new creative ideas in our practices, because creativity flourishes with new ways of looking at the same problem, brought together when people with different backgrounds, training, and experience bring together their perspectives. I believe that an inclusive practice that spans our diverse population, be it economic or cultural, provides us with great satisfaction. Therefore, the motivation for inclusion and diversity should come not only from the desire to create a just society, but also because it leads to more better and powerful creative processes and solutions.
The two-day festival conducted an inspiring conference called Design Manthan to foster creative instincts and imaginative ideas amongst the fraternity. The conference offered meaningful discussions, dialogues, presentations, and much more, providing an insight into the new trends and future of architecture and design.
Every individual was from a different background and their practices were so diverse from each other that it was so interesting to hear different point of views, different challenges that people are facing, people who want to scale up, people who want to scale down, difficulties and how to deal with opportunities within practices, and to get an insight as to how others are doing it.
Well, ours was on social media and its impact on the world of design. So it was interactive with a lot of audience interaction, extremely where people raised quite a few pertinent issues about how it affects us now as design professionals, and how what kind of feedback or what kind of initial feedback and later feedback we're actually getting from our clients itself, and how that affects the quality of design and the quality of work that's coming out.
We had very meaningful discussion regarding a lot of issues, procurement of services, and whether government is a better client or private client is better, and things like that. It was a very nice discussion, and it was heartening to note that, I mean, all of us on the panel agreed that the government is a better employer than a private enterprise.
The festival created a scintillating design experience for visitors with its exhibition, Design Arena. The space displayed projects by renowned architects and designers from India, along with innovative installations by college students.
I think we do have some very good projects displayed this year. There's innovation in design, there's a lot of new ideas, there's a lot of evolution in terms of design. We are living in very exciting times, I must say. So it's good to see and be exposed to design in its very dynamic stage in India.
So there are product arenas that we see out here, the design arena. There are works of known architects which are put up, and there are talks. So these are, I think, inspirational enough for anybody, while they are in profession or they are students or people who are part of this industry in any manner. It's a collaboration of a total complete in its completeness.
The Design Arena also provided the visitors an opportunity to discover and glance at the latest trends in design and technologies showcased by leading brands of the country.
I think one thing it helps is it gets us undivided attention from our customers, because I'm sure they must be meeting hundreds of salespeople. But here allows us to have a more meaningful interaction, allows us space to actually display it in all its glory. They can touch the product, interact with it. We also get to know people personally, so I think all of that helps in actually being able to move the product forward in the market.
I think, like I said, two ways. More than us helping us is the feedback we get and the trends we can see. This helps us in our R&D, in our designing. So we clearly pick up some trends which are happening in the Indian context for sure, and which the feedback goes, and when you get launched the product, it helps to that you are riding the same trends. The other, of course, is what we bring on the table and is of a value to the participants. They see what technology is changing and what Legrand is coming up. So I think it works both ways, our offering to the right audience and taking the feedback of the trends and which we build upon our products.
We cannot get this product to an architect office and showcase, but here, though we have a small display, but we could make the communication clear. Architects really liked our product. We have many people who are visiting and cherishing. So this platform is perfect for products like us.
We have adapted our program to the Asian conditions and tastes. The customers in Asia are evolving. They are very demanding and they know what they want. They want the highest finishes, best hardwares. So they know what they want. And we are contributing to setting new trends.
Endeavor to promote new horizons of the design industry. FOIT provided a platform for young students to not only explore their creativity, but learn and get inspired by leading architects and designers of the country.
What sets apart FOIT is that it engages the students of architecture, interior design, arts. That's the main thing which sets it apart from the rest of the platforms. And the engagement of architects, interior designers, the fraternity with the students and the colleges, it's phenomenal. And that's what is needed, I think, in coming days.
What they have done for students, for young architects, for practicing architects, so they've concentrated quite a lot on work and giving architects of different age groups and different capabilities a platform to show their work.
With an aim to encourage young minds, FOIT 2018 organized various design competitions for aspiring talent from design schools who presented their innovative ideas at the design arena.
I've been actually coming as a jury in FOIT, and it was a great experience because the entries which come to the final jury, they're of very good caliber, and it's always a tough job to ask questions and get answers from the participants.
I was like amazed to see beautiful designs. I mean, young architects, I mean, they're 4 years old, their practice is 4 year old or 3 years old, and they have brilliantly produced beautiful works of architecture.
Design competition, I think it's a great platform for young designers and architects. But I think mostly the beauty of the situation was that all the young architects were full of enthusiasm, and they were trying to, you know, do justice and trying to innovate with whatever constraints that they were facing.
मेरे को लगता है सबसे important होता है कि designers problem को अगर कोई issues हैं उनको कैसे handle कर रहा है, कैसे approach कर रहा है, design कैसे start हो रहा है, that is really very important. And the way they explain their design, and there is crossfire, and there is cross questioning from senior architects who are jurors basically. So that process is quite interesting and very well designed process.
The winners of the first challenge, called the Everest Design Challenge, were felicitated for their innovative ideas in new age construction material and technologies.
Let's get started with the second runner-up, ladies and gentlemen. And the second runner-up of Everest Design Challenge is Sushant School of Art and Architecture, Ansel University. All right, it's time to announce the first runner-up. And the first runner-up is Sharda University. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, and the winner of Everest Design Challenge is Delhi School of Architecture and Design. Let's have another round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the winners.
Winners of another such design competition named Expressions were felicitated for their creative art installations.
Let me also inform you that we're going to be announcing the silver winner, the gold winner, and of course the diamond winner. All right, so the second runner-up, that is the silver winner, is World University of Design. Now time to announce the gold winner or the first runner-up, and the gold winner is Chandigarh College of Architecture. It's time to announce the diamond winner, or rather the winner of this very, very special Expressions Awards that we're announcing. And the winner, ladies and gentlemen, is Architecture College of Business and Design.
The last session of the day was called Detox, a fast-paced chit-chat presentation format where creative thinkers from across design genres came together and shared their views on varied topics.
Every city is defined by its pedestrian experience. And when you don't have that experience, the city doesn't exist technically. So how do you look at bringing the pedestrian back? That's something that we as designers, as architects, really need to think. So what do you do about it? Now, fortunately, I've had the good fortune of being part of an organization where we could work on projects which were at city level and projects which could look at bringing the pedestrian back. So these are three design solutions by the Delhi Urban Arts Commission, where one of the solutions to bring the pedestrian is exploring the greenways, rejuvenating the old cities and creating heritage walks, and connecting the urban hubs through urban skywalks.
So what I want to talk about a little bit today is what I endure, which is the urban life that we have, right? And a lot of you probably endure it as well. We live in cities, but we don't really understand how they impact us. And we have this vision of cities, right? We have this vision of cities that they will be using great forms of transport, we'll have walkable, pedestrian-friendly streets, they'll be safe, there'll be great housing. But this is the reality of our cities, right? Our cities are overcrowded, housing is expensive, it's poor quality, cities aren't safe, as the previous speaker said. And I'm going to put these facts out there. I'll give you a minute to digest them. The first fact, which is, has been around for about a decade now, and this is probably now true globally, right, and can be experienced on a countrywide basis. The second fact is becoming true as we see manufacturing shifting from the west to the east. And the last point, which is, it's not going to be like Delhi is going to double in size or Mumbai is going to double in size, but we are going to have twice the amount of urban area. But is that really a terrible thing, right? We're all given this scenario that cities are, well, they are terrible in a way, but are they really that bad? And is it a problem to do with cities, or is it to do with an idea that cities were planned, designed, and delivered? The idea that 100 years ago people could draw out a city and that is the way it would work. Perhaps that's what needs to end.
Focus. Ideate.
innovate, enable.